keeps getting more information.
Despite criticism from their political opponents, the Republican-led House Intel Committee last night voted to release that four-page classified FISA memo, as it's been referred to.
Yeah, the vote coming only hours after the FBI Deputy Director Andy McCabe was removed from his post.
You to weigh in, and I get to ask the first question since I read last. Is House Oversight Committee Chairman, South Carolina Congressman Trey Gowdy, out here without a heated seat but not complaining?
No, sir.
And I appreciate that. So that's big news yesterday. The memo's on the president's desk. Indications are he wants this. He wants to talk about this.
Yeah, he's got 5 days to decide that it should not be made public. The indications are that he's not going to exercise that. And I would just tell my fellow citizens, if you're interested in whether or not the dossier was used in court proceedings and you're interested in whether or not it was funded by a political opponent, then you'll want to see the memo.
Sure. Congressman, there are Democrats who are saying that what the Republicans are doing with this memo and just a general drumbeat up on Capitol Hill is trying to diminish Robert Mueller and his investigation.
Yeah, I think it was 2 days ago I said I support Bob Mueller 100%. I wasn't a math major. I don't think you can support someone more than 100%. So, look, my Democrat colleagues didn't want us to find this information. They did everything they could to keep us from finding this information. So, of course, they don't want us to
care. Will it be embarrassing to them?
I think it'll be embarrassing to Adam Schiff once people realize the extent to which he went to keep them from learning any of this. So that would be the embarrassment.
What do you mean?
I mean, going to court to help Fusion GPS so we can't find out that they paid for the dossier.
Yeah.
And that they were working for the DNC. That's a pretty big step to go to court to try to keep the American people from learning something. So, look, if it were up to Adam Schiff, you wouldn't know about Hillary Clinton's email. You wouldn't know about the server. You wouldn't know who paid for the dossier. So I do find it ironic that he has his own memo now, because if it were up to him, we wouldn't know any of it.
Aren't we all in search of the truth, though? I mean, Democrats and Republicans should be in search of the truth. If there are a few bad apples, they need to get out. But why is this such a partisan issue when if something wrong happened, we need to get to the bottom of it, figure out who's responsible, and then there need to be consequences. But why did the Democrats have a problem with that?
I don't know, Ansley. My old job, it was about the pursuit of the truth. This job, it is about winning. And I think that's what frustrates people, and that's how you get a 7% public approval rating.
Yeah.
I want to know. I voted to let the Democrat memo see the light in a week when it goes through it. I trust people to make up their own mind and draw fair conclusions, but politics has denigrated to the point that it's about winning and it's about embarrassing the other side. And again, that's how you get a 7% public approval rate.
So ultimately, Trey Gowdy, what are the questions that Trey Gowdy, when the cameras are off and you're talking to your buddies, that you need answered, that you pretty much don't know, but you think you're in the pursuit of?
Well, my main interest is the integrity of the DOJ and the FBI. So if the cameras were off, I would ask my friends at the Bureau and the Department, how pervasive was the bias? I see Strzok and Page, but I want to believe that out of the 30,000 employees,
it's just those two.
I want to believe that. I got a text this morning from an FBI agent who's a friend of mine, and of course morale is low. The Democrats blame us for that. I think morale is low because most people in this country hear the name Strzok and Page, and they associate that with the FBI. I would just tell them that is not the FBI that I ever worked with. And I want to know what the department, this Bruce Orr angle, the number four person, no federal prosecutor that I ever worked with would do the things that Bruce Orr did.
Sure.
So that's what I
If his wife works with Fusion GPS, that might be an indication.
Yeah.
Trey, one other name, Andrew McCabe. Were you surprised that he got removed yesterday?
I was. I spent the better part of 2 days interviewing him on House Intel and then Judiciary the next day. He was a really professional witness. He answered all of our questions. We were together for about 20 hours, I guess, total. I don't know why he left, and it wouldn't be fair to him for me to speculate. So I am grateful for his service, but he's a really important witness in both the Clinton and Russia, and we'll leave it there.
All right. Thanks, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thanks for everything.
Thank
Trey Gowdy.
So
appreciate it.
Gamecocks or Clemson?
Oh, on television or not on television? I had a kid
that
went to both schools.
That's a politician right there.
I had a kid that went to both schools.
All right, coming up next, the Fox and Friends grand finale here in Washington, and you don't want to miss.